Last week here on Thunder, the West Virginia Mountaineer made its debut for Johnson's Motorsports Race Team and took home all the glory. They currently hold the checkered flag. Will they hold on? Two of the July season here on Thursday Night Thunder as we get set to release 16 of the baddest diecast monster trucks as we get set to go head-to-head racing. Bigfoot fell short last week, losing out in round one. They're looking to get that checkered flag back, but they got to go through 15 other monster trucks to do it. As you see here, Rich Wagner in the Captain's Curse still trying to dial that brand new ride in, and Sudden Impact made it to the finals last week, only to fall three-quarters of a truck short. The trucks are ready, the drivers are ready, and I believe the fans are ready. Are you guys ready to go diecast monster truck racing? We're getting ready to kick off round one. Well, ladies and gentlemen, coming up first here in round one action, we're going to see the return of the Summer Heat Shootout Champion. That's Matthew Riley, now behind the wheel of the El Toro Loco machine. Didn't do so hot last week. He's looking to turn things around. But in that far lane is Richard Nelson II, right out of the Diggers Diecast race team. He drives the Megalodon. Both trucks are staged as we kick off week two of the July season. Who's moving on to round two as we go green? Down the straight now, El Toro pulling a hard lead up and over the cars. El Toro lost it in no man's land. And Richard Nelson is going to move on in the Megalodon machine. He moves on to round number two. Well, up next here in round one action, we've got the return of that 1972 Titan Chevrolet driven by Zach Gerge. New kid on the block here. He draws up over in the far lane, Chantel Bailey, a two-time Thursday Night Thunder champion. She also took home the Legends Championship back in December. She's looking to put Scooby-Doo on top. She's got to knock out Titan as we go green. Both trucks are hard off the line. They're even approaching the jump up and over no man's land, and Scooby-Doo is hanging right there with her. However, Zach Gerge playing to that Chevrolet horsepower in no man's land. He moves on to round two. Well, up next here in round one, we've got two rookies about to go head-to-head on the MTA circuit. Logan Wallard out of Granite City, Illinois, pilots the Taurus Chevrolet, and in the other lane, it's Jason Wook in the Prowler machine. Both trucks are staged at the MTA starting line. Who moves on to round two action? Taurus, Prowler, as we get set to go green. Both trucks seem even off the line, down the straight, up and over, no man's land, and they come across the finish line. I'm not sure who got the win. I don't know who got it. Was it Prowler or was it Taurus? We're going down to a photo finish, and your winner will be Prowler. He moves on to round number two. Well, up next here in round one, we've got the return of Donald Price Jr., a two-time Thursday Night Thunder champion. But in that far lane is Braden Varga in the Donkey Kong machine. You know he's got that truck set on kill right here tonight. You got to watch out because he will send that thing to the moon if you let him. Both trucks stage now as we get set to go green. Down the straight stretch now. Son of a Digger with a slight lead up and over the cars. And Donald Price Jr. and Son of a Digger will upset the Donkey Kong machine right here in round number one. Well, up next, we've got the return of Ben Wishart, who made it to the finals last week, taking on the West Virginia Mountaineer. He lost out by merely a fender of a truck. But in the near lane is seven-time Thursday Night Thunder champion Rich Wagner out of the Wells Motorsports race team in Captain's Curse. They're still trying to dial that truck in right here tonight. Boat truck stage now. Sudden Impact. Captain's Curse as we go green. Down the straight stretch now. They're even up and over no man's land. And Captain's Curse put down the horsepower in no man's land. Sudden Impact goes from the finals last week to a round one elimination. Well, up next here in round one action, we've got Chad Legit 2 Legit, the Maximum Carnage champion, now driving for Bad Weather Racing in the Tropical Thunder Chevrolet. But in that far lane, you see him and you better fear him. That's Colt Cobra out of Cobra Creek, Colorado in the Ford Brass Eagle Snake Fight. Boat truck's got it set on kill. Who moves on to round two as we go green? Down the straight stretch now. Boat trucks are even up and over the cars, and what a finish across the line. But your winner's going to be Chad Legit in the Tropical Thunder Chevrolet. Colt Cobra's going home. Well, up next in round one, correct me if I'm wrong, but the year is 2021, right? Not 2000, because Goldberg is set to take on the Gravedigger. In the far lane is five-time Thursday Night Thunder champion Bradley Graham and Goldberg, and then Aaron Church in the near lane in the Gravedigger. Boat truck stage as we go green. Gravedigger and Goldberg are down the straight, up and over the cars, and Gravedigger's on two wheels into the wall. Oh, my! Gravedigger has leaned it up on the wall, but I do believe he did get the win over Goldberg. Both of them came across the finish line with a lot of steam. Gravedigger, MTA track crew and officials are going to have to pull him off the wall there.
but what a wild ride for the Gravedigger.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, next up, as we get set to close out round one action, Mitch Brown returns, the three-time Thursday Night Thunder champion out of Pacific, Missouri in Bigfoot. But in that far lane is the rookie of the year thus far. That's Jeffrey Skipper and the West Virginia Mountaineer. He has been on a rail here lately. Boat truck stage as we go green. Two bad boards going down the straight, up and over the cars in Bigfoot. Looks like he got the win over the West Virginia Mountaineer. We're going to go back and take a look at a photo finish. Jeffrey Skipper hanging right there with him, and it's going to be Bigfoot by half a truck moving on to round two. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break and head down to the pits of the Gravedigger team. The crew is going over the truck after they just laid it up on the wall, taking on Goldberg. They let it all hang out, no doubt about it. The Gravedigger team trying to make sure that truck is back at 100% for round two action. Goldberg was hanging right there with him, but this may just be the start of the Gravedigger-Goldberg rivalry right out here on Thursday Night Thunder. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're getting ready to kick off round two action of Thunder, and up first, we've got the return of the Titan Chevrolet, who laid down a bad fast pass, Zach Gerge, in the 1972 Chevrolet pickup. He draws up against the Digger's diecast Megalodon, Richard Nelson II, behind the wheel in the far lane. The drivers have been complaining about that right lane most of the night in round one. But the right lane is actually where Megalodon got its first round one victory. As we go green, Megalodon and Titan down the straight. Titan pulling a lead on a Megalodon, trying to play catch up. And the Titan Chevrolet will outrun the Megalodon machine. He moves on. Well, up next, Donald Price Jr. brings back the son of a digger machine, the former two-time Thursday Night Thunder champion out of Poplar Branch, North Carolina. But in the near lane is Jason Wook and the Prowler Machine. The rookie made his debut this July season. He's looking to start taking names out here on the circuit, but he's got a big one to conquer right here as we go green. Son of a digger, Prowler are down the straight, up and over the car, and Prowler takes the win. What a huge upset by the Prowler Machine. He knocks out Son of a Digger as we go down to the MTA replay. Slight lead to Son of a Digger, but watch as they hit the first jump. Far lane up, near lane down. Boat trucks heading to the finish line, and that's what the drivers are talking about with that right lane. Prowler takes the win. Well, up next, we've got the return of Chad Legit, the Maximum Carnage champion, in that bad weather racing Tropical Thunder Machine. But over in the near lane, we've got the return of the seven-time Thunder champion at a Wells Motorsports, Rich Wagner in the Captain's Curse Machine. Boat trucks are staged as we go green. Boat trucks off to a hard start, up and over No Man's Land. Trouble for Captain's Curse, and that was just enough for Tropical Thunder in that dreaded right lane to come back and take the win. We're going to show you what happened down here in the MTA replay as they come over that first jump. Watch Captain's Curse riding up on two wheels, and that man slowed him down and cost him because Chad Legit takes the win. Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, we get set to close out round two action. Bigfoot out of Pacific, Missouri, Mitch Brown behind the wheel. He is set to take on the black and green Wrecking Machine out of Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina, Aaron Church behind the wheel of Gravedigger. Boat trucks are staged. Ford versus Chevrolet here in round two. As we go green, Gravedigger and Bigfoot heading down the straight, up and over the cars. Gravedigger's out of shape, and Bigfoot and Mitch Brown take the win. The big blue Ford moves on. The bow tie's going home. Well, ladies and gentlemen, before we get to semifinal action, we want to remind you that July 31st, the All-American Throwdown is coming to the Monster Truck Attitude YouTube channel. As we get set now to kick off the semifinals of Thunder, up first is the new sensation rookie, Zach Gerge, in that beautiful 1972 Chevrolet pickup, Titan. But in the far lane is Jason Wook in the Prowler Machine, who has been pretty fast all night. Two rookies find themselves in the semifinals. Only one can go on to the finals. Boat truck stage as we go green. Prowler drills him off the line down the straight, up and over the cars in trouble. Prowler turns it over in the shutdown area. I'm not sure who did pick up the win, but we are going down to the MTA replay. You see Prowler had the lead on Titan. Sick air by Prowler. Gets out of shape in no man's land. End over end crash for the Prowler Machine. The Titan Chevrolet does pick up the victory, but Jason Wook and the Prowler Machine has completely tore that truck up, flipping it end over end as they approach the shutdown area. Now the MTA track crew and officials are down there to roll the Prowler Machine back over, and you can see the damage done. He has got a lot of work to do, and so does the crew, to get that truck back together for next week's episode of Thursday Night Thunder. What a wild ride by the Prowler Machine, ladies and gentlemen. Now Titan moves on to the finals. Who's going to meet him there? Chad Legit out of the Bad Weather Race Team brings back the Tropical Thunder Chevrolet, but in that far lane is three-time Thursday Night Thunder champion out of Pacific, Missouri, that big blue Ford, better known as Bigfoot. Boat Truck Stage, Ford and Chevrolet to close out the semifinals as we get set to go green. Down the straight stretch now. Boat Trucks are even up and over the cars, and Tropical Thunder turns it over. I don't know who got the win. We're going to have to go back and check out the MTA replay. Boat Trucks came across the line almost at the same time. Bigfoot laying down all that Ford horsepower. Watch Chad Legit in the near lane. Lands the truck. Looks like he snapped the tie rod in, spun the truck around, rocked up and rolled over. Mitch Brown and Bigfoot move on to the finals. The MTA track crew and officials are down there now. And what a mess they got with the Tropical Thunder machine. He was letting it all hang out, trying to take out Bigfoot. The crew's going to be thrashing on that truck. They might as well join Prowler down in the pit section, because Tropical Thunder and Prowler have suffered some significant damage out here on the track tonight. But the Tropical Thunder team trying to make a name for themselves out here, and what a better way to do it than to take out Bigfoot. Unfortunately, it didn't happen tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're heading down to the pit area now to check on the Tropical Thunder machine and the Prowler machine. Both crews are down there in the pit area, thrashing hard, trying to get their trucks nice and tight back together for week three of the July season. Prowler obviously got the worst end of the deal with that end-over-end crash going towards the shutdown area. But we did confirm with the crew chief of the Tropical Thunder machine, they did snap a tie rod in no man's land, and that's what kicked the rear steer out and slung Chad Legit towards the wall. He had no choice but to hit the brakes and turn the truck over. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is what we all come to see. It's final time here on Thursday Night Thunder. Mitch Brown returns in that big bad Ford out of Pacific, Missouri, Bigfoot. He's looking for victory number four out here tonight. But in that near lane is the beautiful 1972 Chevrolet pickup, better known as Titan, Zach Zurge, looking for his first Thursday Night Thunder championship. Ladies and gentlemen, Bigfoot, Titan, it's showtime here on Thunder down the straight stretch. They're even up and over the cars, and the Titan Chevrolet comes up short. Bigfoot gets the win out of that right lane, the one the drivers were talking about all night long. The big bad Ford out of Pacific, Missouri, puts the Chevrolet on the trailer. Look at him even down the straight stretch. You couldn't ask for a better race. A slight bobble for Titan. Up and over no man's land, they're pretty much even settled down. And the Titan Chevrolet, something might have happened, but Bigfoot takes the win over the Titan machine. So congratulations to Mitch Brown and Team Bigfoot on your fourth Thursday Night Thunder championship. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the points as we close out week two of the July season. In the latter half of the bracket, Megalodon leads with 13, followed by 10 points by El Toro Loco, Scooby, and Taurus. And at the top half of the bracket, it's a battle for point supremacy. Mitch Brown leads with 25, followed by Jeffrey Skipper, matching him with 25. And in third place, Zach Jurgens and Titan with 20, followed by Ben Wishart and Sudden Impact with 20. And ladies and gentlemen, the points battle's getting serious, but we hope you enjoyed this episode of Thursday Night Thunder. If you haven't already, be sure to crush that subscribe button, and I'll catch you down the road. Thank you, guys. See you next week.
Standing tall up in victory lane, I done brought the pain, and now they're screaming my name. Yeah, everybody saw me rock the place. Now there's flash bulbs are popping and mics in my face. In my face, always giving the crowd what they need. Now they're wearing my shirts, front row to nosebleed. Now the crowd forms, it's what it's all about. Signing autographs until the lights out. Yeah, it's about that.